This Toyota Corolla is the perfect example of a fuel-efficient sedan that people buy to make their trips to the gas station a bit less painful.
But that's old school thinking. These days, electric vehicles are changing the game and the way we think about how much every mile costs. This Ford F-150 Lightning is a wildly inefficient electric vehicle, which means that it takes a whole lot of electricity, measured in kilowatt hours, to take us where we want to go. But if you break it down by cost per mile, would you believe that this big old truck can still beat an efficient gas-powered car?
Hey everyone, I'm Lauren.
And I'm Desola.
And we're from Edmunds, where we're known as the car testing pros. We've teamed up with the experts at CarMax to help you find the right vehicle for your need. Now, obviously, the Corolla costs a lot less to purchase than that Ford. I mean, it's almost $100,000. But that's all beside the point.
So Lauren, today we're gonna look and see how an efficient gas-powered car can stand up against an inefficient electric vehicle. You know, in terms of how many bucks it takes our cars to get 100 miles.
All right, well that's fair enough. Speaking of bucks, just wanna make sure we have enough left over for lunch, cause you know, sis is always hungry.
I'm like, I know that's right.
My Corolla is a go-to car if you want to save a little on fuel. Now, if you take a look at the national average of gas prices, combine it with the fuel economy of this car, and do a little math, you'll find that you'll spend just under $12 to go 100 miles. Now, of course, those prices may be higher or lower depending on the area in which you live in, which is exactly why we've decided to just stick with the national average. Keep it on an even playing field.
That's not bad for gas, but that's actually more than you'd spend to go the same distance in this Lightning. If you take a look at the national average residential cost of electricity, the consumption rate of this car, and do a little math, it'll only cost you $7 to go those same 100 miles. Did you hear what I said? $7. And like gas, prices may be higher or lower in your area, so be sure to do your homework.
Okay, Desola, that all makes sense, and it's cool if you're charging from home. But let me ask you this. What happens when you need those electrons out on the road?
Well, you know, the reality is that most EVs really have plenty of range for daily use, so at-home charging is definitely the go-to. But when it comes to road trips or, you know, those unexpectedly long drives, then yeah, I guess it does change the equation a little bit.
But just for the sake of argument, if you only charge at public fast chargers for one reason or another, you'd be looking at an average cost of 33 cents per kilowatt hour, which brings the cost to go 100 miles up to almost $15.
So yeah, the Corolla has an advantage there.
All right, look, all this driving has made me hungry. Let's get something to eat. Wait a minute, how'd you get a drink? How could you even afford that?
Well, you know, since I charge my Lightning at home, I've been saving a couple bucks, so I decided to treat myself.
Okay, treat
yourself. Don't worry, Lauren. I got you covered. It's fine. My Nissan Leaf is a way more efficient EV than Desola's truck. It only cost me $5 to charge up for 100 miles, so I had plenty to cover your drink and upgrade mine.
Okay, well, thanks. Getting an efficient electric vehicle can save you on, say, fry money, but even an inefficient electric vehicle like the Lightning can still cost you less to fuel than, say, one running on dinosaur bombs.
Exactly. And don't forget that your driving style can have a huge effect on how efficient your vehicle actually is.
That's right, kids. A lead foot and a low fuel bill don't mix.
All right, so we gonna eat these or what? Because the way this food is smelling, it's about to mix real well in my stomach.
I know you're not about to drink that.
I was gonna give it to you.
Anywho, you guys, be sure to like and subscribe to our channel to see more videos about electric vehicles, fuel economy. Thanks so much for watching our video. We'll see you next time.